Hi. Back with Apache. You'll have to excuse the last video that I put up. I had the air conditioner going. And I forgot. So, yeah, enjoy my air conditioner running in the background. The Maus. One of my favorites. Not real relative today, unless you play it just right. I like it. Let's play it. No camo. What's the point? There is no bush big enough in World of Tanks to put this bad boy behind. Tier 10, World of Tanks. A little longer load time. Really looking forward to the games coming up. All of them. Any of them. Fractured Space, been putting a little time in that. I'll have a video of that today, later on today. I'm doing World of Warships and World of Tanks here in the beginning as I commentate to get used to commentating. I know these games. I'm comfortable. I'm able to sit here and talk to you while I play. And I see the mistakes that I'm making in other videos when I go back through and edit. Again, I've said this in a past post. I'm not going to cover chat. So, it's a mature game. It's a free-to-play game. So you can only imagine what's going to pop up in chat. I'm pretty sure I have the filter on. But, you know, kids these days are pretty creative when it comes to being vulgar. I don't be vulgar just to be vulgar. I will curse. I was in the Navy. I learned how. I'm better than you. T-49 doing what he's supposed to do. I love it. M-103. Gorilla. And if you can't hear me, sorry. You might want to turn it up a little bit. I'll get a little closer. E5. Food for the monster. I'm not afraid of any single tank in the game. Maybe the Russian mediums. Too small. If they get too close. That's not a good spot, bud. I know it looks good, feels good. Not a good spot. And the key to a Maus is to get to the front line, to get into the fight before your team dies. And it looks like in this map that he wasn't happy about that. Yes, yes, shoot the Maus. Shoot the Maus. And this is where the Maus is supposed to be. Get your turret out. Lock it. Unlock it, fire. Rinse and repeat. Of course, I'm not shooting APCR. 57 over there. Ah. Out of practice. Don't know where to shoot them. Yeah. Fire that heat, baby. Oh, is that a disconnect? I believe it is. We'll take it. Your service provider killed you. Congratulations. Yeah, let's get that. Aww. You know what? I do see the right side failing there. Maybe not. They're doing all right. Doing all right. Yeah, I do have my filter on if you'll look in chat there. This is where a mouse is supposed to be, right here. Scaring them. Making them shoot parts of the tank that they aren't going to bounce on. I mean, they aren't going to pin on. This is my world, bud. Not yours. Out of position there, let him get too close. Made a couple of bounces that I didn't want to make. 95 got a shot on me. 95's reloading. Who shoots the bottom mantlet of a 95 Apache? Come on. My team needed me then, too. Fell master. And I don't care about putting every one of my failures on the video. I'm going to be as realistic as possible. Pushing into the teeth of a T-28 prototype. Little handy fire there. E5, good tank. Seem to be doing pretty well. Bobcat seems to be competent. 263. We really need the free roam camera in World of Tanks. Ow. That would be the Gorilla. Or the 95. Probably the Gorilla. They wouldn't give it an American gun that did that much damage, would they? I enjoyed the 95 when I went through it. Wouldn't do it again. Nope. Not today. Glad I don't have to. Yeah, lost position. A T-49 and a 263. Both one shot. You could breathe on either one. T-49. Well, he's got all his faculties. No camo. T-49 with no camo. Interesting. New way to run it. He's going to go back here and give some water to to the Arty. Let's go hit that building first. You guys all right? How y'all doing? Good, good, good. I presume that he's going to the other flank. Maus has got a lot of help. Last time I saw him. Yeah. We can call this fat lady. Let's go get another tank. Maus, good tank. 4502B. Good time. What do y'all want to play? Play the ugly monster? You know what? As you can see, P100 probably primary. Clan Wars tank. The E5 is probably more relevant than the E100 now in Clan Wars. I don't know. I haven't played Clan Wars in a long time. When I got out of Clan Wars, it was, believe it or not, there was a lot of mediums. A lot of DPS in mediums. No gold. We'll start out with regular. Only switch to gold when it's imperative. You absolutely have to have it. Quite a bit going up to the hill. Let's anchor the right flank. New tank. At least it's not a tank I've ever seen before. 1309, bat chat gun. Interesting. I'm a coming. Same situation in E100 and in pub matches. Your only relative if your friends stay alive when you get there, by the time you get there. I hear you, big guy. Reloading. Ooh, nice bounce. No, I'm not gonna go out there, big dog. Smart. I can't shoot around you there, big dog. You're in a bad spot, partner. And now Apache's in a bad spot. Of course. First pin's gonna get my engine. Second pin's gonna get that. Try to keep your armor as good as you can get it. Try to make them shoot at me. Not the E-100. Oh, are you serious, buddy? E5 nudging me in the middle of the shot. Yeah, not doing too well. Yeah. No shots fired. All pins. E-100 failure there. I wanted to talk a little bit today, and I'll use this opportunity to watch as my E-100 burns. Talk about the XVM situation in World of Tanks. It's destroying it. And I mentioned in the last video that World of Tanks may be spiraling in North America, and one of the reasons is the XVM is destroying the opportunities. And if you don't know what XVM is, and I'm not even sure I'm saying it right, I have no mods on my game whatsoever. I used to run with a zoom out mod only. I don't even run that anymore. I don't care about loading it up. The XVM sniping situation and the XVM situation altogether, it's not just the fact that another player, an enemy player, can see how good or how bad you are, or whether their team is going to win or is not going to win. It's all of those things put together. A kid loads up a game and he has a 33% chance of winning hit this match. So says an XVM program, a third party program. So he suicides. He runs into the middle of the map, gets another tank, goes and does it again. He doesn't care about his win percentage. He doesn't care about his team. He doesn't care about anything. And especially kids that aren't raised in an honorable society. And unfortunately, there are people playing in the North American server that aren't raised in an honorable or honest society. I'm going to leave it at that. You can put what you want together. It takes a lot of good people that work really hard to put together a school or a channel on television that kids can watch and learn how to act. What I'm trying to say is, in certain parts of the world, they aren't able to do that. So kids don't get what they need to be loyal or honorable or good people. I don't know how else to put it. To be consistently good. Everyone's good. Everyone's bad. They have the potential to be all. But to do it on a consistent basis, they need guidance. And in some third world countries, there are none. Not their fault. They don't do it intentionally. It's just a product of the way they act. whether they have the money to do things like that or not. I am not a bigot. If you knew me, you would know that this was true. This 155-58, he's gonna kill somebody. You watch. Oh no, there was too many. Speaking of a good tank, but being able to act good on a consistent basis, all kids can. I'm not going to play the E100 again. I don't think y'all want to watch two matches in the same tank. Not many people play the 92 anymore. Let's see if we can get a match and drop a Volkswagen on someone. But if they... if they're not... if they don't feel like they're being watched, people that don't know how to be good on a consistent basis will not be good. And online, no one's watched. So, you know, anonymity creates poor decisions in young brains, young minds. So, you get a situation where XVM is used to detrimental effects in a game. World of Tanks, they didn't put it in there for a reason. I don't feel like it should be in there. And I know that people like Cookie Baby and Mingles, and they don't care. They think XVM is fine. I've noticed that. I've never seen Mingles or Jingles with XVM on his. So, you know. I just feel like XVM is taking away. And when I say XVM sniping, nobody ever knows what I'm talking about. It's a term that I think I heard somewhere and I repeated. It's the act of shooting the highest ranking player in the game. Hunting them down. If you have a 48% chance of winning, and you have a 62% player on the other side, on the other team, you take him out, and your chances of winning goes up. You know what I mean? So you go and kill the 62%er. That's a bad spot. And this is why the 92 is no longer relevant. There's more spotting in the game, but the spotting is spotty. It's not as long as it should be. I'm not going to be able to focus on any one tank long enough for my reticle to come down. In some matches, I can. These guys here are going to be my focus now. I mean, if I'm not firing, we're not winning. So I'm going to go to the people that are lit the longest. And I'm going to focus them down. Oh, you poor 58, 54. Enemy armor is destroyed. If your guns aren't firing, you're not going to win. And most of the time, even if your guns are firing, you're not going to win. I'm not 51% after 20,000 games for no reason. I'm stupid, but you know, not quite that stupid. Yeah, the Conqueror smells it. He's like, ooh. Back up again. Have a Volkswagen on Apache. team's doing well. Got good coverage, middle, flanks. That E5 on the right could be in trouble. I'm not gonna be able to help this 54 unless the E100 continues to chase. And he may. No, he decided to go back. E4 is going to light up the E100. Well, he may be chasing. While I was talking to 53, 55 on my team, got position, which is what I should have done. Just as soon as I launched a very expensive shell. Ooh, I hope I didn't hit it friendly. That's the two matches. As soon as I get some people watching, I'll have more entertaining stuff to show you. Because the requests are what's important. Since that was so boring, you know what? I'm gonna put some medium play. I'm gonna play three tier 10 mediums in one video. So look forward to that. And I think I'm gonna call it on this one. Let me know what you want to watch. Later.